day.
Is all that big sword? Oh, if he's, then ouchie, ouch!
The sword of the Mekonis.
The entire valley below. The whole thing is its sword.
Something seems unnatural.
What do you mean?
Look, that flowing light. From the way it glows, it has to be ether. But it looks like it's being drawn in by something.
By the fortress. It should just be up ahead.
Father once told me that the Mekonis absorbs the ether of the Bionis and uses it for sustenance.
So the Mekonis feeds off ether?
Then undoubtedly the ether serves as the Mekon's energy source as well.
It looks so big, even from this distance. The fortress must be enormous.
Galahad Fortress, the frontline base of the Mekon. The Mekon that attack Bionis must all come from here.
Then there's a high probability that he's there. The golden Mekon that took Fiora. We're about to enter the Mekon stronghold. If there's anyone who wants to turn back now.
Shulk, friend should no split up. No leave friend behind. Ricky's scared, but Ricky won't go too.
Ricky.
He's right. Okay, let's go.
Yes.
What's that?
A supply convoy. It would be most unwise to proceed without restocking our supplies.
You arranged this for us.
Hayes!
Dixon!
Looks like you lot have been having fun without me. Heard you took care of that faced Mekon.
What are you doing here?
I got wind of some allied force coming together a few days back. I stepped up as the representative of the Homs. Then a little birdie told me you lot were heading for Galahad Fortress. So I thought I'd drop by and say hello. I've got a whole stack of new equipment. Want some?
Yeah! I was hoping for some new stuff.
Hold it, Ryan. You know it's gonna cost you.
You cheap old man.
Thank you.
This isn't going well.
Don't give up. I'm right next to you.
This isn't going well.
No loose spirit. He's back.
Hey there! Fiora? You mean Dunban's sister?
Yes.
So that's why you're all looking so down. I can't believe they're sticking HOMs into those faced Mekon. Looks like they weren't just eating us.
They made Mumkar into one. He was the one who attacked Colony 9.
Oh, and there was me thinking he snuffed it in that battle.
Aren't you surprised?
That he attacked Colony 9? I don't know what drives those Mekon. I've given up trying to figure them out. It don't surprise me one bit. Still, Mumkar as well, eh? Things are getting interesting.
Sorry?
Oh, nothing.
It is time for us to return. I would like to continue providing assistance, but my help is required in assembling HOMs for the Allied Force. There are also my duties as Seer to consider.
Then I'll be off too. You lot should be all right getting Fiora back. In the meantime, we'll be getting ready for battle.
Thanks for coming this far. We'll be fine. We can handle ourselves.
Galahad Fortress is a key position for the Mekon. You can't just rush in, all guns blazing.
Agreed. We will infiltrate via the ether inlets. If I'm right and the Mekon do feed off ether, then we're sure to find some form of influx channel. Our objective is to reach one of those channels.
Don't go dying on me, Shulk.
I won't. You take care as well.
Cheers.
Looks like it's just us.
Right. We head for the hilt of the sword. Galahad Fortress.
Okay.
1 year on. Now, at last, we will seize our destiny. Isn't that right, Choke?
So another has appeared with the ability to wield the Monado. But why would Zanza release the Monado? He surely knows it would become a double-edged sword. Yet he relinquishes it to that mere child. And a face escaped my control and acted alone. Now that the Monado has been freed, it appears the usefulness of the faces has come to an end. Although, perhaps there are still things to be learnt from having them challenge the boy.